Welcome to River Bend and Puppet Parade with Jasper and Baby Bird. Grandma, sing a song. And that bunch of animals with special musical guests and other funny puppets as we learn together about God's special plan for us.
Hey, Jasper, what are you doing?
Hi, Baby Bird. I'm thinking about something.
I know. You're thinking about something.
I just told you that.
But what are you thinking about?
I'm thinking about what to do.
Maybe I could help you.
I don't know, Baby Bird. This is something that's hard to talk about.
Well, you could share it with me in riddles. I like riddles.
Okay, then. How about this one? What gets bigger the more you take out of it?
Oh, that's easy. A hole.
Well, that's just what I found myself in. A hole.
You mean you've dug yourself into a big hole?
Kind of. I want to be loyal to a friend of mine, but I also want to be a servant of God.
What does that mean?
My friend wants me to help him lie, and for me to tell his parents that he was at my treehouse when he was really walking around the mall.
So do you obey your friend and his lie? Or do you obey God's word to tell the truth?
You're right. I need to obey God first in my life.
That's what you've always told me. What should you do? Oh, what should you do? If you're feeling unsure, what should you do? Oh, what should you do? If you don't know the answer, what should you do?
What should you do?
Who can you turn to? Oh, who do you know? If you're just not sure, who do you turn to? Oh, who do you know? Ask the Lord to see you through. Just ask the Lord to see you through. Just ask the Lord to see you through. What should you do? Oh, what should you do? If you're feeling unsure, what should you do? Oh, what should you do?
What should you do?
If you don't know the answer, what should you do?
What should you do?
Who can you turn to? Oh, who do you know?
Do you know?
If you're just not sure, who can you turn to? Oh, who do you know? Just ask the Lord to see you through. Just ask the Lord to see you through. Just ask the Lord. I think they are right, Jasper.
Yes, the Lord can help me with this problem.
I'll bet you just wanted to run away and hide.
It crossed my mind, Baby Bird.
Ask yourself this question, Jasper. Should you trust God or your friend?
I don't want to do the wrong thing.
That's easy. Just do the right thing.
You're right, Baby Bird. I want to put my trust in God first.
Well, Jasper, you are not the only person to have this problem.
Hey, Remember the story of Jonah?
Jonah and the big fish.
Yeah, the whale. The big fish that swallowed Jonah.
The Bible says it was just a big fish.
Do you know of any big fish that could swallow a man?
Okay, then we'll call it a whale.
A whale of a story it is.
That's a story about obedience, Jasper. It's the big word that means obey.
That's kind of like just what I'm going through with my friend who wanted me to lie for him.
Put your faith in God, Jasper.
Jonah put his faith in God, but that was after he had some doubts.
Right. He didn't want to trust the Lord at first.
I know.
I think if you ask for help, maybe that would cheer you up.
Let's ask Grandma sing a song about it.
I'm sure she knows a good song that can help you about your problems. It's the same one that Jonah had, right, Grandma?
You're right, baby bird. Jonah's story is all about obedience. When God told Jonah to go to the city of Nineveh, he told Jonah to tell the people that they were wrong. He told Jonah to tell the people that God will punish them because they did not obey the Lord. Now let's meet our first special guest. This is Neil Moore. Hiding behind that big accordion again, right, Neil? Welcome to the Puppet Parade, Neil Moore. Tell us what your song is named.
Well, it's named Jonah and the Whale, a prophet that when he was told to go to Nineveh, ended up on the way to Tarshish and then ended up in the belly of a whale, which goes to show you that when the whale threw him up, that a backslidden prophet can even make a fish sick. So you have to be a little careful on that and do what God tells you to do. Amen. So Jonah and the Whale.
Jonah and the Whale.
In the Bible we are told of a prophet who was called to a city that was steeped in awful sin. All the people in that place seemed devoid of saving grace. Well, the prophet was afraid to enter in. Now this prophet forth was sent that old Nineveh might repent. But instead of that, to Tarshish he set sail. Well, the winds began to blow. Overboard did Jonah go. And he found a mercy seat inside a whale.
Inside a whale.
Over there.
Over there.
Over there.
Over there.
Well, he'll tell us all about it over there. On that hallelujah strand, I'll take Jonah by the hand. And he'll tell me all about it over there. In the cold and briny deep, tears of grief did Jonah weep. Well, the big fish threw him out upon the shore. Old Jonah went his way, preached to Nineveh night and day. I guess he'll never backslide anymore. Now some people won't believe that a whale could him receive. That doesn't make my song at all untrue. There are whales on every side with their big mouths open wide. And beware, my friend, or one will swallow you. Over there. Jonah by the hand, and he'll tell me all about it over there.
Grandma! Grandma!
Hi!
Hi! I was just in the backyard feeding the chickens, and I was feeding them chicken feed, and, well, anyway, I was listening to the song you were playing, and is that true about Jonah?
It sure is. He was swallowed by a big fish.
Whoa. I wonder what that's like.
I don't know. It must have been deep and dark in there.
I know. And that accordion playing, that was pretty good.
Did you like that?
Yeah. In fact, I think I'm going to try playing that one time.
You are?
Yeah. I think I might just go buy one.
Well, I hope you get a good accordion.
I hope so too, but they're probably a lot of money.
Well, some of them are.
Yeah.
You can find a used one pretty cheap, though.
Maybe Neil will let me use his.
I'm sure he will. I'm going to go ask him.
Oh, good. See you later, Grandma.
Bye, Zippy.
Bye-bye.
I think Jonah was scared to do what God wanted.
Yes, he was. Instead, Jonah ran away. He got on a big boat and tried to run away from God.
Is that when the big storm hit the boat?
And the other sailors knew Jonah was the cause of the storm.
Like a big hurricane.
Even worse, a super storm. One that would sink the boat.
And all because Jonah was running away from God, asking him to tell the people of Nineveh to obey him.
Right, baby bird. But it gets worse for Jonah.
I'll bet those sailors weren't happy with Jonah.
Jonah told them he had disobeyed God, and the sailors better throw him overboard if they wanted the storm to stop and to save themselves.
Wow! It looks like the ship was about to sink.
But as soon as Jonah was tossed overboard, guess what?
What?
The sea became calm.
What happened to Jonah?
God sent a big fish, a whale, to swallow Jonah. And in the belly of the whale, Jonah learned a special lesson.
He learned to obey God, no matter what happens to him.
And after 3 days, God told the whale to cough Jonah up.
That's in the song Grandma just sang.
I know, but here's another song from that bunch of animals about Jonah and the whale.
Jonah was a prophet of God. To Nineveh, Jonah was sent. Now he disobeyed, and God was dismayed. In a ship to Tarshish, Jonah went. God had prepared a big fish. It swallowed Jonah that day. The fish got sick, and Jonah was saved. Jonah went forward with God. Jonah was in the belly of a whale. To Nineveh he set sail. God said, Jonah, you better get that bucket. You're gonna have to bail. When you get to Nineveh, do as you're told. We don't wanna do this again. God loves you, Jonah, and God forgives. Just don't let this happen again. Just don't let this happen again.
After that trip with the whale, Jonah went right to the city of Nineveh and told them what God had said. The people agreed and promised to set aside a special time to fast and pray. When God saw the people change, they changed their ways and God forgave them. Nineveh was not punished. Here's a little song about it called Trust and Obey. Jonah learned to trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Oh Lord, you saved old Jonah from the belly of the whale. Oh Lord, you saved old Daniel from the great big lion's den. You save a little Moses on the river Nile. The water was rough and cold. I know you can keep me safe, oh Lord, while I'm growing old. Old Jonah learned to trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Old Jonah learned to trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey.
Remember, God told Jonah to go to Nineveh and give them God's message.
Until Jonah went to Nineveh, those people did not know the difference between good and evil.
I know. Why didn't they listen to God?
I guess because sometimes we think we know what is right.
But God tells us what is right and wrong, doesn't he?
He does. We just have to listen to him and read the Bible.
I'll bet Jonah was sorry for not listening to God's words.
Finally, when Jonah was in the whale's belly, he decided to obey God's word.
And God gave Jonah another chance.
He sure did. He also gave the people in the town of Nineveh another chance, too.
I think that's great. God gives us a second chance.
When we believe in God's word and obey, we don't need a second chance.
Now I know that it is better to obey. I'm going to do just what my parents and God wants me to do. Right, Jasper?
Just let God into your heart. You can hear him.
To hear him is to obey.
Right. Grandma, sing a song.
God loved everybody, even the people of Nineveh. Sometimes people want us to do the wrong things in our life, but God can help those who pray to him for guidance. Right now, I want to introduce the Emmons. Christina, would you introduce your sisters?
Well, the song we're going to sing is Children of God, and I'm Christina, and I'm 15.
And I'm Victoria, and I'm 13.
And I'm Natalie, and I'm 11.
And I'm Stephanie, and I'm 9.
Something woke me up from my nap.
So you're sleeping again on the job.
Don't get me going, country hen. What's all this racket about?
It's not racket, Grandpa. It's music.
Well, okay then. I'll just go back to my nap.
Grandma, while he's sleeping, let's play some music. And I can sing a good old country song about what you all been talking about. Give me a flat. Make that an A flat. Ready? Go. winter's coming on. Well, I sat around and sat around this old coop too long, way beyond my due. Yes, sir. Oh, do Lord, oh, do Lord, oh, do you remember me? Do Lord, oh, do Lord, oh, do you remember me? Lord, oh, do Lord, oh, do you remember me? Way beyond my coop. A chicken coop, that is. What's that snoring? Grandpa, Grandpa, time to get up again.
You know, baby bird, when it's the word of God, it's very easy.
Now you can tell your friend, you obey the truth of God and don't lie about it, just like Jonah did, or learn to be faithful to God.
You're right again, baby bird. First, I'm going to obey God. I'm going to learn what God wants me to do, not what my friends want me to say.
To dig yourself out of that hole you created, you better ask for God's help.
I dug a big hole for myself, baby bird, but now I know better.
What are you going to tell your friend?
Well, I'm going to say that Jesus wants me to tell the truth.
No matter what?
I'm going to tell him that Jesus is my special friend also.
Maybe your friend can meet Jesus.
Then he will know about God's special love.
He will know Jesus.
You're right, baby bird. I'm not going to run away from God. I'm going to ask him to help me and help my friend too.
Now you've got it. Jesus gives us all another chance.
To obey God's words, and I'm going to start all over today to pray and help me obey God's words.
How about you try the Bible with him?
Great idea, baby bird.
The B-I-B-L-E.
Yes.
That's the book for me. We stand upon the Word of God. The B-I-B-L-E. The L-O-V-E love. Jesus shows for me the sacrifice, he paid the price, the B-I-B-L-E. God shared his love, God shares his love from up above, the B-I-B-L-E. We stand upon the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. You've gotten a lot of good ideas today, Jasper.
Yes, I have. I know how to help my friend.
If you show your friend Jesus, maybe he could become his best friend.
We could all be great friends together.
I like that idea.
You know, baby bird, God's word is always true.
I'm going to do what God wants me to do.
Just like Jonah did.
Right. I'm going to trust and obey God's word. I feel better already.
And so do I. Until next time, let's all lift up our hearts to God.
And I'm going to follow God's message with all of my trust.
Bye-bye, baby bird.
Bye.
Bye-bye, everybody.
You'll find it in the Bible. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.